3 days ago, 73 teens met together and came up with an idea for a show that we believe would be a great addition to the Netflix lineup. This show follows the story of Samson. The lines for the show can be found in the Bible in the book of Judges, chapters 13 through 17, and we believe that with the action and with the fighting and with the romance, this show would be engaging and gripping for your viewers at Netflix. We find three seasons outlined in the story of Samson that would make a great show for Netflix. In season one, episode one is called You Done Messed Up. In episode one, we find the nation of Israel under the oppression of the Philistine nation because they had turned their back on God. And for 40 years, the Philistines oppressed and put in bondage the nation and the people of Israel. They cried out for a deliverer, and God answered their prayers after 40 years. Episode two, we begin to see God's answer to the prayers of these Israelites as we find a man and a woman. His name was Manoah. He and his wife tried and tried and tried to have children, but they could not have children. One day, an angel appears to Manoah's wife and tells her that, in fact, God says she's going to have a son, and this son is going to be special. This son is going to rise up and be a judge and a deliverer for her people, for Israel. Manoah is not there, and he's a little skeptical, and he's very confused and a little overwhelmed at the thought that an angel appeared and that his son would be this deliverer. So he asks for this angel to appear again. He prays to God and asks to understand what does he need to do to raise this interesting and unordinary child. Episode 3 is called Taught by an Angel. The angel reappears to Manoah and his wife and tells Manoah and his wife that this child is going to be a very special child. He's going to be abnormally strong. That this child, in order to receive that strength from God, is going to have to live a very weird life. He's going to have to live the life of a Nazarite and never cut his hair, to let his hair grow out long, to never touch anything dead or anything unclean, to never drink alcohol or go near alcoholic beverages and places where they make alcohol. Manoah and his wife are still very overwhelmed by the whole ordeal, and they make a sacrifice to God. And as they make a sacrifice to God, this angel disappears in this sacrifice to God. That's where episode 3 ends, and episode 4 is called It's a Boy, and it picks up with the birth of Samson. This woman who had never been able to have kids gives birth to this child, names him Samson. He starts growing, he starts becoming big, and he starts becoming strong. And then we learn that the Spirit of God comes on Samson and begins to stir him, and not just give him physical strength, but supernatural strength. This boy is destined to do great things for God. Season 2 begins with an episode called When a Man Loves a Woman. Samson, who has been given this gift from God, falls for the wrong woman. He falls for a Philistine woman, a woman who is one of Israel's captors, and he begins falling in love with her three times. His heart is, and his eyes are drawn to her. And even though his parents try to advise him against it, he says, I want to marry that girl. The next episode is called Riddle Me This, because when Samson is visiting this woman, her Philistine guy friends, they meet with Samson, and he proposes a riddle to them, and he makes a bet with them that in 7 days they can't solve this riddle, and these Philistine men are full of pride and they've got to know this riddle. So they put the pressure on Samson's fiance, and she turns on all her womanly wiles. She puts on the guilt trip on Samson, and finally, after days and days, she wears him down. He gives her the secret to the riddle, and then she tells her companions, her Philistine companions. They come to Samson, and they tell him the answer to that riddle, and Samson becomes very upset. Samson kills several of the Philistines, and he gets upset, and he runs off. And the next episode, we call episode 3, is My Big Fat Philistine Wedding. Samson comes back to the village where his fiance lives, and he's ready to marry her. And much to his disappointment and much to his amazement, he finds out that his fiance's father had already given her in marriage to his best man. Talk about a great show. Talk about an interesting episode. Samson goes into a rage. He captures 300 foxes, ties them together by their tails, puts torches in between their tails, and sets them loose in the Philistines' grain fields, burning their grain fields to the ground. Needless to say, the Philistines are very upset by this. They pursue Samson, and he's hiding from the Philistines. They eventually capture him, and he's tied up. Episode 4, the end of season 2, finds Samson tied up. He breaks those bonds and he finds the jawbone of a dead donkey. We call the episode Death by Donkey. He finds the jawbone of a dead donkey and single-handedly he slays 1,000 Philistine men. This is one of those areas in which the show will earn its mature rating, which we'll talk about later. Episode 3 begins with Samson having judged Israel for 20 years, being that deliverer, being that judge that God had raised him up to be. But we realize that Samson, his choice in women, his love life would turn out to be his downfall. We find in this first episode a turn for the worse. Samson sleeps with a prostitute. And as he's there at her house, the men of the city surround the city thinking they have a chance to finally remove him and to finally kill him. They wait at the city gate for him. Samson comes out, literally picks up the city gate, takes it outside of town, and escapes these Philistine men that had surrounded him and ambushed him. Episode 2 is called Hey There Delilah. Samson once again falls in love with the wrong person, a Philistine spy, a Philistine sympathizer named Delilah. We learn that he's not married to her. He's in an immoral relationship with her and visits her many times. And Delilah tries to discover for the Philistines the secret of Samson's strength. So she'll turn on the womanly wiles once again and try to get Samson to tell his secret. How are you so strong? And Samson lies to her on multiple occasions, gives her the wrong answer. She becomes increasingly frustrated and distraught that Samson won't tell her the truth. She turns on the guilt trip. She pulls out all the stops to try to get Samson to tell him his secret of his strength. And finally, Samson turns his whole heart over to Delilah. He tells her that his strength is in his hair, that if his hair was cut off, that he would no longer be supernaturally strong. So Delilah puts his head in her lap and sings him to sleep. And as he falls asleep, she cuts his hair off and calls the Philistines in. The next episode is called Betrayed and Alone, because Samson wakes up to Philistines surrounding him, and he thinks he still has his strength, and he goes to fight him and then realizes his hair's been cut off. He doesn't have his strength. He doesn't have the Spirit of the Lord on him like he used to be empowered. And the Philistines arrest Samson. They put him in a prison camp. The Philistines are so excited and they're so full of pride that they have captured him. In episode 4, it's called I Went Out Like a Wrecking Ball. They find that Samson is great entertainment. They want to have a party to celebrate their capturing Samson. They have this party with thousands of Philistine in a building, in a colonnade held up by pillars, and they bring Samson out to laugh at him. Samson has had his eyes gouged out so he can't see where he's going. A boy leads him in to be made fun of, to be laughed at, to be ridiculed in this party, this immoral party where people are worshiping pagan gods. Samson asks the boy to bring him into the middle of the building where the pillars are, where the columns are that hold up that building. Samson prays that God will one more time fill him with the Spirit and give him that supernatural strength, and God does. Samson leans on those pillars that hold up the building, taking the building down, killing thousands of Philistines along with himself. In this story of Samson, we see a man who is greatly used by God, but also a man who was very much human and whose love life, whose lust, whose eyes were his downfall. Our teenagers got together and made the following recommendations for this show. The title of the show will be Of Love and War, highlighting both Samson's military victories, his victories in fighting, and his defeats in his love life. For the rating, we've suggested a rating of TVMA because of violence, fear, and suggestive scenes. For casting, we recommend casting Jason Momoa as Samson. We also recommend casting Rowan Blanchard as Delilah. For a short summary of the plot, we have this. Samson is natural on the battlefield, but clueless when it comes to his love life. Follow the story of Samson as he struggles between the tension of God's call on his life and the destructive power of sin. His story is a reminder that even the strongest among us are totally dependent on the grace and mercy of God.